Take me home, where there'll be no sorrow. All is peace and joy forever. We will sing redemption song. Jesus, I will praise Him after all for His
here unto Thee. I want to be. Dig a little deeper in the storehouse of His love.
I want to shine.
Jesus, dig a little deeper in the storehouse of His love.
Now don't you want to
dig a little deeper?
Jesus, que te manda. Also including the one who welcomed us.
Ufuna titokozeso mpingo chifukwa cha kubwera kwanu.
I would like also to thank the church members here for coming today.
Sete kudziwa kuti ndi chifukwa chani tasankha njira imene tikugwiritsa ntchito lero.
I don't know why we have chosen to use the method that we're using today.
Tikamaliza mwina tingathe kukhala ndi yankho.
Maybe when we are done, we will have an answer.
Amene atiwerengera Bible,
the one who read the scripture,
awerenga mbuku lopatulika la Luka chapter 23,
read from Luke chapter 23,
maverse oyambira 39 mpaka na 43,
starting from verse 39 up to 43.
Ndiwerenga nanunso.
I'm going to read again.
Kuti tikhale limodzi.
So that we are together.
Mbuku la Luka 23 verse 39.
Luke chapter 23 verse 39.
Bible likuti.
The Bible says.
Verse number 39.
Verse 39.
Ndipo mbodzi wa ochita zoipa.
And therefore one, let me find it so I don't translate.
Verse 39.
Ndipo mmodzi wa ochita. Then one of the criminals who were hanged blasphemed him.
Ananchitira iye za mwano nanena.
Blasphemed him saying,
Kodi suri Christ iwe?
If you are the Christ,
udzipulumutse weka ndi ife.
Save yourself and us.
Koma winayo anayankha nadzudzula iye nati.
But the other one answering rebuked him, saying,
Kodi suwa pa Mulungu?
Do you not even fear God?
Boona uri kulangika komweko.
Seeing you are under the same condemnation.
Ndipo ife tuti kuyenera pakuti tiri kulandira zoyenera zimene tinazichita.
And we indeed justly, for we receive the due reward of our deeds.
Koma munthu uyu sana chita kanthu kolabwa.
But this man has done nothing wrong.
Ndipo ananena Yesu.
Then he said to Jesus,
ndikumbukireni mmene mulowa ufumu wanu.
Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
Verse 43.
On verse 43.
Ndipo iye ananena naye.
And Jesus said unto him,
indetu ndinena ndiwe lero lino.
As surely I said to you today,
udzakhala ndine mparadizo.
You will be with me in paradise.
Tipemphere.
Let us pray.
Atate mu utumiki wa lero.
Father, in the service that we have today,
mulankhule ife tikhale chete.
Speak to us and we will be silent.
Mu utumiki wa chinyamata.
In this service for the youth,
mutiphunzitse.
Teach us.
Kukhala okhulupirika koposa kale.
To be faithful more than ever before.
Popeza tapemphera mu dzina la Yesu.
For we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Professor wina wa school ina.
A certain professor from another school.
Ophunzitsa ukadaulonduka chenjedwe wa ulaliki.
Who was teaching a master's and doctorate in.
Ine pokhala klasi ya ukachenjedwe kumeneyo.
I, as one of the students in those classes.
Adane na maunati.
He said.
Pastor Mazengera.
Pastor Mazengera.
Muka tzakala pa pulpit.
When you are on the pulpit.
Musa dzaseweretse mwai mene Mulungu wakupatsani.
Don't play with the opportunity that God has given you.
Chifukwa udzakhala ukulalikira uthenga wako otsiriza.
Because you might be preaching the message for the last time.
Utatha kulalikira uthenga.
After you finish preaching,
ungatsamwalire.
It is possible that you could die.
Ukozanso kukhala uthenga.
It might also be a message.
Umene ukupita kwa munthu wina.
Which will go to somebody else.
Amene akaudzwa uthenga.
Who after hearing the message.
Ni uthenga wake otsiriza.
It might be his last or his own.
Chotero.
So,
usadzaseweretse mwana.
Don't play with your opponent.
Uthenga wathu masana wa.
Our message this afternoon.
Mutu wake tikuti.
The title is
kuseweretsa mwai.
Playing with your opportunity.
Njira yopita ku planta yapaparula.
The way that leads to planta.
Nyamata wina adarengezedwa kuti wamwalira.
It was announced that one boy was dead.
Ndipo achipatala adatsimbika kuti wamwalira.
And the people at the hospital said yes, indeed he is
dead. Mfumu adalandira uthenga.
And the chief received the message
kuti maliro ndiwoyikama.
That the burial was going to be the next day.
Mwambo wa maliro udayamba.
The funeral procedure started.
Worira amalira.
The people who were crying cried.
Inu amene simulakale pa mwambo wa maliro ku Malawi.
Those of you who haven't been at a funeral procedure.
Maliro aku Malawi.
At a funeral in Malawi.
Sufu sakuti kodi wa malirai wa malira nchia.
You don't ask that to the one who died.
Umamvera kwana malira.
You just hear from the people crying.
Ama kuusa mena kulirira.
They tell you in the way they are crying.
Kuti wa malirai.
That this person who died.
Anadwala.
He was sick.
Sana dwale.
Or she wasn't sick.
Wachitangusi.
Or he died through an accident.
Umamvetsera makuya kwana malira.
You hear a lot deeply from how they are crying.
Ye mkulu wa malirai.
And this person who died.
Mwamba uli mkati.
As the crying was going on, the procession was going on.
Oimba daimba.
The people who sing sang.
Olalikira dalalikira.
The person who was to preach. Preached.
Atsukula nenyamula ulendo kuma.
And the poor bearers took the funeral.
Kuma chonda kuitsachi yamba kuchitika ulendo kuma.
But as they were going to the grave.
Boko sirida yamba kugunda.
The casket started, you know, shaking.
Mbi yamu Malawi.
The story in Malawi.
Yan huakufa.
Of people who are dead.
Ndiyakutintawi sina. Chonda kuitsachi kachitika. Samalan.
Is that sometimes when something strange happens, you better be careful.
Kutenga omalira yafuna adzuke.
It might be possible that the one who died wants to wake up.
Osati kudzuka kumoyo komano kudzuka chinthu.
Not that he wants to wake up as a person, but that's
Akasaluke nkango.
It might be a lion.
Kusanduka joka.
He might wake up as a snake.
Gimbe na danga kukunda ku.
And when they started hearing this bumping on the
casket. Bokos.
The poor bearers of this casket.
Adaya ngana na wina ndi mzake.
They looked at each other.
Vena manta.
And they started being afraid.
Adayamba. Wasiransa.
The people who were afraid, they started leaving the casket to others.
Ena warimbantima.
And the ones that were brave.
Adapita be matsogoro.
They went forward.
Anamalira atamva.
When the people who were crying heard this.
Vena adayamba kurila kumachoma bwerera mbuyo.
They started crying but going backwards.
And pambiri adat zizwan zwachitikazo.
A lot of people were surprised with what was happening.
Po Peter Harry.
After a while,
kukunda kudali mbikirabe.
The bumping in the casket continued.
Wan kwada karabu da witswabe.
People were surprised.
Kufikira mbena adafika kumanda.
And until when they reached the grave.
Mamba kumanda.
The ceremony at the grave.
Pamateka kanthawi kutitike bokosima.
It takes a while before you actually put the casket.
Kumanya matawa adapangana kuti tikafika tingoponya.
But the poor bearers decided that when we reach there, we
just
throw the casket in.
We na ori bantima that.
And then the one of the brave ones said, no, no, no.
Banchi tiyembekezere tuone kuti chuchitika njiani.
Why don't we wait and see what is happening?
Mena daika potel.
When they put the casket down.
Asana marize kuri ikapans.
Before they finished putting it on the ground.
Chapa mamba chaboko usijida. Tida tsebuka.
The top lid of the casket opened.
Ah, tsuku adaona umarilaya akudzuka.
And the poor bearers found the person who was
dying. Chifuwa chambiri ya Malawi.
Because of what happens, the stories in Malawi.
Vena menada ngona umarilaya akudzuka.
When other people saw this dead body waking up,
adaye sanzukwa.
They thought that it is probably just a ghost.
Adaye mbali wiro kutawa.
They started running away.
Kumawena olimbantima.
But some brave ones.
Adati titamkwira titaona.
They said, let's touch him and see.
Nala mkulana naye.
And spoke to him.
Adapeza maundi emweyo.
They found out that the voice was the same.
Womarira adari atatsuka.
The person who had died had the reason.
Anamarira adabwe.
The people who were crying came.
Vena namkupatina.
Some of them actually hugged him.
Ndichimwemwe chao.
And smiling and with happiness.
Adayamba ulendo upita kumuti.
They started going back.
Mbiri inamveka pose pose.
This story was heard all over.
Fuzulanga masarawa.
My question to you this
afternoon. Muda kakala omarirayo ndiko.
If you were the one who had died.
Matsuka. Jenjiramanda.
You have just.
Lokumba kumba.
The grave was already dug for you.
Inu mapurumuka tsenjera manda lokumba kumba.
And you have been saved from this grave. Maybe before I even come to this question.
Yame ndakupatsani choganisa.
Let me give you this to think about.
Chabi naomalilayo ndakuna.
Okay, this person who died is here.
Ndekena kano yafika nkhawi yodya nsima.
And therefore it's time to eat.
Ndekumukuganisa mmene akudya kuti bambo wako adamalira.
And then you're thinking as you're eating that this person.
Oh my God,
maybe this person who died is somebody you were singing
with.
And as you're singing, you're thinking this person we're singing with died. And that person who died is your father. Let's go away from there. If you were the one who had passed
away,
how would you have conducted your life?
Nditafusa fuso lomwe.
If I can ask this question.
Kwantu ena.
If I have asked this question to other people.
Ndida esa kufusa fuso lomwe.
I asked to ask this same question.
Kwantu ena.
To other people.
Adati.
They said.
Moyo wanga unakasintha.
My life would have changed.
Ndidakadziwa kuti Mulungu andipatsa mwai wachiwiri.
I would have known that God has given me a second opportunity.
Koma kodi mukudziwa dzankuruyi.
But do you know about this man?
Mene mbiri dapita patai.
When this message went all over.
Avadatsuka kutaka muone.
People came to come and see him.
Koma ndozopetsa chisoro.
But unfortunately.
Adakamuone nani kukachaso.
They found him at the drinking
parlor.
He found him with a bottle in his
mouth. The people asking
him were saying, oh, I said that you had
died. And he was answering and
saying, oh yeah, they're saying that I actually did.
Kode. It
is the one that actually was saved from the grave. That is that what they do?
Masanawa.
This afternoon.
Tikufuna tione mbiri ya mtanda.
We want to see this story about the cross.
Tikamakambira na santa.
When we talk about the cross,
sisi kugambira na za mtengo umele Yesu adango pachikidwa hapo
hiyo. We are not talking about the tree that Jesus was crucified.
Tikugambira na zaifa ya Yesu yochititsa manyasi.
We are talking about the death of Jesus Christ, the shameful death.
Ifa ya iye amenada renga inundine.
The death of the one who created you and me.
Kubwera kutsiko la pansi.
To come to this earth.
Kutakara mutsiko la shimani.
To come and live in this sinful earth.
Muntu amenada murenga iyeyo.
The person who created him.
Na kanisa soka mpachika pamtanda.
Decided to go and crucify him.
Ndingani mene tukambira na masanawa.
This is what we are talking about this afternoon.
Koma pachirika atipangani.
But in the middle of this story.
Yakona pamtanda po pamene Yesu ana pachikidwa ndimbaraziwe.
Is the story about the place where Jesus Christ is crucified with two thieves.
Mbala ina inari kumkono wa manja.
One thief was on the right hand.
Mbala ina kutsanja la manze.
The other thief was on the left hand.
Zochitika sapa mtanda.
The things that happen on the cross.
Zimtibata makuru awiri awat.
It is giving us two kinds of people.
Mene tinawerengela Bible
moja. The way we read the Bible.
Oremba Bible.
The one who wrote.
Adachita kuika oremba nkani mene.
He said the person who wrote this story.
Adachita kuika and huwa mogwirisa.
He put these people together.
Chifwa and hu tima ganisa kuti mkono wa manja.
Because we think that the right hand.
Ndi mkono wa mpamvu.
Is the strong hand.
Mkono wa manzere.
The left hand.
Ndi otambizira.
Is the one that just actually held.
Ndi akuika mbalaina mkono wa manja.
So he puts one of the thieves on the right hand.
Mbalaina mkono wa manzere.
And the other thief on the left hand.
Timafuna mutalinga lila zantu hamena akala pamtanda.
We want you to think about these people who are
akala achitamai kukala pamtanda ndi mulengi.
They have an opportunity here because they are on the cross with the Creator.
Zina za pamtanda.
Some things about the cross.
Pamtanda.
On the cross.
Antu wadali ni ndawi zofana.
People at the same time.
Pamtanda omena ada pachikidwa osewa.
On the cross is where they were.
Kujoka pamtanda wa Yesu.
Coming from the cross of Jesus.
Muringo wake.
The distance.
Udali wofana.
Was the same.
Koma ndi pamtanda pomwepa.
But it is on this same cross.
Pamene wina adasankha kugwiritsa ntchito mwayi.
When one of them chose to use his opportunity.
Koma wina adasankha kuseweretsa mwayi.
And the other one chose to play with his opportunity.
Ndi pamtanda apa.
It is on this cross.
Pamene tikupeza magulu awiri awantu.
Where we find two kinds of
people. Kuloyamba la wantu.
One group of people.
Ndi gulu la wantu.
Is a group of people
losoweretsa mwai
that play with their opportunity.
Munjira imene.
In this way,
tikuiona mbala ya kumanzere.
We see the thief on the left
yosoweretsa mwai
playing with his opportunity.
Kusoweretsa mwai wake adatani.
How did he play with his opportunity?
Mene adali pamtanda.
When he was on the cross,
ndiye akulankhula mawu achipongwe.
He speaks in words that are disparaging.
Mawu amene akulankhula kuti.
What he is saying is this.
Kodi iwe munjira ina tisadanene mawu amene akulankhulidwa.
Before we even come to the words that he is saying.
Kuseri kwa mawu amene akulankhula.
Behind these words.
Kuli mawu achipongwe.
He is talking disparaging words.
Kodi iwe.
Saying, hey.
Sinda kuona kuchirisa Lazarus.
We saw you healing Lazarus.
Ukututa Lazarus.
We saw you raising Lazarus.
Tibakuona tu iwe.
We used to see you.
Ukumachurukita idenga kare somba.
We saw you multiplying fish.
Umagani sa chiyan.
What were you thinking?
Pahanotu ni pantanda ba.
Here is the cross here.
Ndeta sewe iradu ni zimeno machita ziki.
Okay, try to do what you were doing.
Tatsipuru muta. Ndeo kutsipuru mute.
Okay, try to save yourself.
Neolemba akatsiri olemba wena.
And then the people, some people who are right have said.
Adaremba zankuru amena adali kumkono wa manja.
They have written about the person who was on the right hand.
Ife timawerenga mawo khawa ameneno akunena nguru wa kumdzanjala manjari.
We are only concerned with the ones, the voice that the person on the right said.
Mawo ngonena kuti adati.
The words where he said.
Iwe.
Hey you.
Ife tutikulangika ndi machita chita watu.
We are being punished here for the things that we did.
Koma ife.
But we.
Tikulangika ndi machita chita watu.
We are being punished for what we did.
Koma Yesu.
But Jesus.
Ngosa chima iye.
He hasn't sinned.
Timaona mau amenewa.
We look at these words.
Koma nolemba wena kuti.
But some people who have written have said.
Mene mbala ya mkono wa manja ima yanga.
When the thief on the right hand side was answered, in his heart he was filled with sorrow. He was touched. So when he replied to this other thing, he started with words that said, hey, you. This way he was saying he was tied. You should be careful that I am tied up here. You could have heard me if I wasn't tied. Is it true? As he was doing so, he was even trying to free himself from the tree. And then he said, you should be careful. And he said to Jesus, leave him. But remember me in your kingdom.
Maguru awiri anthu.
Two groups of people.
Guru la kosweretsa mwai.
People who play with opportunity.
Mbava yakudzanjala manze.
The thief on the left hand side.
Paliso ndwe na mina da sweretsa mwai.
There are also the people who played with their opportunity.
Njira yakutanda wena adakora chovava chake mwinjiro wake.
On the way to the cross, other people took his
clothes
and played with them. Forgetting that it is this
cloth
which when somebody just
died
was healed from a disease she
had.
But the people played with this cloth.
Some
people were even doing casting lots. This is what happened at the cross. Some people in their ignorance and slapped Jesus. And they said, okay, tell us who hit you. Some on the same cross spat on Jesus. When I'm talking about I'm not talking about you who have washed your teeth
with.
I'm talking about people. You should think about people in the village. They have eaten chiponde. And they haven't even brushed their
hands.
And in the unbrushed with their teeth, they spit on Jesus. Playing with opportunity. I'm talking about the cross here. Some on the same cross. They made him wear a crown of thorns. I'm talking about the cross here. That people played with their opportunity. So when we get away from these people who played with
their opportunity,
there's a certain group of people that used their opportunity. The thief on the right hand
side
is number one. He is saying that for me to be here on the cross, this is an opportunity here. some of the people that use the opportunity.
Nakuritsa chito mwa ibotherata.
And you use this opportunity.
Ni Simon wa Kukirene.
Is the Simon of Cyrene.
Ataona kuti Yesu watoka ngita.
When he saw that Jesus was tired of
coming. Iye akumulandira Yesu mtanda.
He decided to help Jesus in carrying.
Maho wake idali njira yake opita mtanda.
This was his way of going to the cross.
Wena amati kugorogota.
Going to Golgotha.
Wena osemeleta mwai. Amenada kugiritsa chito mwai.
Some people that have used their opportunity.
Anali Yosef wakuli matea.
Was Joseph of Arimathea.
Kuona kuti Yesu wafa.
When seeing that Jesus had died.
Anakuna msalu zapa mwamba.
He took very expensive
gold.
And asked that he could
bring the body of Jesus.
And he bought this expensive grave so Jesus could lay
in it.
Using one's opportunity. When we are talking about the thief, the one that used this opportunity, I want you to look at him and he should some of the people that have written about the Bible have seen
him.
Because he was a thief. There are people that think that he must have been carrying things. So he must have been very healthy and had big muscles. And he had old legs. And also had the long eyelashes. His eyes were always red. And sometimes when he just looked at you and opened his
eyes, and walk
away, people were just afraid and started running away. But it was this thief on the right hand side. Instead of playing with his opportunity on the cross, he looked at the one on the left and told him to shut up. But looking at Jesus, he said, Jesus, remember me. Playing with your opportunity. Three things that I would like to share with you
today.
Quickly, we are going to share them with you. People who use their opportunity are the ones that use their challenges.
They
are people who turn their challenges into stepping stones for their success.
In the principle of Benedarima Zacchaeus.
This is the principle that Zacchaeus had.
Angeles Amadi Zacchaeus principle.
White people say this is a Zacchaeus principle.
Muipesa Luke chapter 19, verse 1, paragraph 4.
You find it on Luke 19 from verse 1. People who use their opportunity. They are the ones who turn their challenges into a stepping stone for their
life.
When Jesus is passing by, Jesus really wants to see Jesus. Zacchaeus wants to see Jesus. But he sees some challenges. His problem number one is
number two, Ayuda, komaso pusira. Sana funa Yesu azikumana kumana ndi ochimwa.
The second problem is that the Jews and the others, they don't want Jesus to meet sinners. So they covered the way so that Zacchaeus could not see Jesus. But be careful with Zacchaeus. Because Zacchaeus says, they change their challenges to be a step. He said, I want to see Jesus. But these people are preventing me. The people who have written
said,
Zacchaeus ran faster
than
he did not just run. He went and climbed up a tree.
Ama kulitsa chito nga.
People who use opportunities.
Ama tembeluza zopechera kukara step ya chibambana.
They turn their challenges into a stepping stone.
Tano ya karuina. Tano ya karuina.
A story of a certain dog.
Mene tano itinka irena kumalawi. Sinka mpeka muhinoya.
When I was saying this story in Malawi, it wasn't properly.
Chifuwa mene wambama chitanda agaru sili matiwa.
Because the way people deal with dogs. With
Kani ikuti. Karu ada kira mjeje.
The story says the dog fell into a.
Mwini karu akaona wakara mjeje masikwa wina tat.
The owner of the dog, having seen that the dog had been in the war for 3 days,
then pesa karu afokerat.
He found that the dog was very weak.
Ada esanjira yon chota mene.
He tried to take the dog.
Ada repera.
He fell.
Mukutiwa inokufunikira kwa karu kuno.
You know how important dogs are here.
Pakadani repera, pakadani repera.
Somewhere where I was
working.
Somebody's.
Because
I did not greet.
That is here.
I said, what?
Kundikalipira, eti sinda mpatse monigaru, sinda ti hai, kwa gabu.
You are angry with me because I didn't say hi.
Ya, kwa siwa huli kwa za kukutela nchitu.
So they said, you know that I can
fire you. Eti sinda mpatse hai, gabu.
Because you did not say hi.
How is sinda, eti niti sweet, darling, kunena gabu.
Sometimes they say sweet, sweet or darling talking to a dog.
Samu yesa gabu, kuposa sare, yanga yose kumala.
The food that is given to dogs is much, much
malo gona garu ni malo amene ne sinda gonepo.
The place where a dog sleeps is much, much better than where I've slept.
Nekurui ataona kuti wafoka.
This person, having seen that the dog was so
alerti manseru kuti basikaru wanga wata.
He said, oh, I think my dog is.
Yada kani sabuti njira ina ninga mulemekezele garu ne kungo fotsera ni fumi onene ni bomepa.
So he said, maybe what I should just do is just to bury him where he is. So he called some boys to help. So the boys started with their shovels. As they were pouring this dirt into the
soil,
they were surprised. That this dog had the
Ezekiah's.
When the dog see how the dirt was coming in,
so
the dog said, oh, this is playing now
here.
So he was saying, he was doing when the shovels had the dog would shake the dirt. From it and all the dirt would go down. And then the dog would go from this corner to the other corner. And so when the dirt came, the dog would shake it back and it would go where the dirt was already, so it would
go.
So the people who were doing this job
surprised
that instead of the dog being covered, the dog is climbing up a little until the dog came out of this hole alive. The dog used its challenge to be a step for its
salvation.
People who use their opportunities.
Are
people who use their challenges to be their opportunity. They see how the shifts are going. And they don't have time to write assignments. But they look at the shifts as a step towards their success. They see how the country is going. And they know that time is very important. And they use their challenges to be a step for their
self.
I have seen the youth who see that this subject is very difficult for them. But they use that difficult subject to be a step for their success. The second point, people who use their opportunity are people.
They
are people who never give up.
ogwiri tachito mwari.
People who use their opportunities.
Kwa hivu mbuziwa kwa hivu wina adati.
Do you know that somebody who has written said,
zimene zima chitika pamtanda.
The things that happened on the cross.
Adali satana ata wera pamtanda po.
It was Satan who was there on the cross.
Kufuna kumkweza pae Yesu.
Trying to discourage Jesus. So that the, when Jesus sees the situation, he should just decide just to give up. So that maybe Jesus should not die. And if he didn't die, salvation for the world would not be. The one who has written has said, in Satan's mind was this. If Jesus sees this very
person,
he is going to use his godliness. And I agree with him. Because Jesus at this point could have just said, don't forget that I am God. We maybe just said so you just so that you
should.
It would have gone down from the But if he had done so, the earth would not have been saved. People who use the opportunity are people who don't give up. He was spat upon. He was beaten. He was put on a crown. But he did not give up. This type of behavior, it was also seen in
Joseph.
Joseph, who saw that his dreams were not seen properly, but he went ahead. He did not go behind. People who don't play with opportunity. People who use the opportunity, they don't give up so easily. There's a story about a girl in
Malawi.
The examinations in Malawi, Malawi Examination Board, is given only once a year. But this girl had written this exam.
Masamu wanga kundiuza kutakare mba zaka zingati maesu ama nebo.
What does your math say? How many times?
Zaka 8.
She wrote 8 years.
Nitsika na.
This is a girl.
Adakare mba koyamba.
When she first went to write.
Chifangani kutakare mba koyamba.
When she first went to write.
Amane wadamba tamasikisi kuma onzo no.
The Manebu gave her 6, but the 6 were put upside down.
Amene
so,
they, 9.
So they were 9.
Sada give you. Sada wetere mpai.
She did not give up.
Adakakara tsika na wina.
If she was somebody else,
adakati ndingo kwati wai.
She could have just said, I'll just get money. I'm going to stop.
Komadare mbanso, chaka chajiwi.
She wrote the 2nd year.
Amanebu jihongwe.
On the Manebu being
so bad, a statement.
They just gave a statement. If you're given a statement, it means you're
going to die.
She did not give up. She wrote the 3rd time. She just kept with only one subject. The 4th time, she only passed 2 subjects. Then they saw the time. She also had the 9s.
Kenako.
Then
Adabwera Nipunsiro Limoti Loka.
She only had one subject that she
could.
But when she wrote the 8,
6 points.
She came up with the 6 points. The people that were interested in finding out, they said, we have a scholarship for you.
Scholarship to China.
And they found a scholarship for
her. Degree to China.
She got her degree in China.
Mene asada marize degree ku China.
Before she finished her degree in China,
ukama mariza, masters.
There was another organization that said we are going to give you money
to do your masters.
When she finished her masters, they said, okay, we have money to give you to do a PhD. This last year,
PhD program.
She was in the second year of her
PhD.
If she was she wouldn't be in a PhD program. Boys and girls who use the opportunity
are
youth that are not discouraged. They are the youth that when they find a
boy,
they are going to be
very from nowhere.
And then the boy will go from somewhere and say, and then they'll start crying and say, oh, I'm not going to
be crying.
They don't get discouraged. They actually wait on Jesus
for knowing that Jesus is the one who gives
money. Youth that use opportunity are the ones that look at the problems of school fees, and they don't go backwards, they go forward. Opportunity comes and people will say, look at how this boy or girl is doing, give her tuition to go to school.
And to us, we need to money.
People who use opportunity.
Ndamene sabwets from high.
Are people who don't get discouraged.
Sama give here.
They don't give up.
Chachitatu.
The third point.
And who need to money.
People who use their opportunity.
Pepero lima karamuya kwa.
Praying is their food.
Ndiruguda ba inendanya matavena.
I am surprised with
other
who want their future to be bright. But from morning to dusk, youth, if you want to be youth who are powerful, have a prayer in your heart. This world, things don't happen because you're intelligent. Because you are clever. Or maybe you know too much. But things happen because of prayer.
Kalani anyamata ndatsikana apemphero.
Be youth who are prayerful.
Pemphero lima pereka mphamvu.
Prayer brings power.
Pemphero lima chinjirisa.
Prayer will cover you.
Pemphero lima kuuza zvinereka kare wapakukambirana zvatsogorwa.
Prayer will tell you what people are talking about you about.
Pemphero lima pereka zosowa zvakumtima kwako.
Prayer will give you what you're missing.
Ndima umene udari mwaYesu.
This heart was in Jesus.
And amene amakulitsa chito mwana.
People who use.
Ndi anthu amene pemphero limakhala kudya kwawo.
Are the ones that use prayer or.
Ndikuonani kukuuza kuti tsopano kodi tikupita kotsetsereka.
I'm looking at you and they're saying, babe, are we going down? The answer is yes. Wait for us here.
Fuso kumati, kodi no anthu awawatawa nenawa.
The question is, are these people who don't use opportunity? Do we have them among us? Do we have them in our generation? The answer is yes. I've seen youth that play with their opportunity. When I was in Malawi, I know a guy that was given opportunity. God gave him a chance to learn tonic
songs.
And when he was conducting the songs, he was very good with his hands. What they didn't know is that with his hand gestures as he was conducting, he was telling other youth, people, boys and girls that were going, he was going to meet them.
Pamba pito panthawi.
In the end,
adapezeka kuti mwabuka mimba muguloimba.
One of the girls in the group was pregnant.
Zimateka bwanji.
How did it happen?
They
say, well, they, when the choir master was doing his hand gestures, he was
going to
meet. He was playing with his opportunity. I have seen news that play with opportunity. The opportunity that God has given
them
to be in God's church. But also to do things in the church. But they play with this God-given
opportunity.
Let me go to families now.
I've
seen other families that play with opportunity. I've seen married women who are married to a very
husband.
A husband who is very calm.
Amuna osalata, china chape chika chika.
A husband who doesn't talk too much. He speaks very calm. But he is married to a woman.
My wa puma.
The woman who is
how is uncontrollable.
Sometimes when the husband comes home,
I'm a fika poala atila bamwapewa.
He comes and
knocks
when the children
and
say, where were you?
Awana na kuti iwe wotu ne bambaka juli.
And when they're saying this, they're saying to the father. And when they say, where
are you?
And then the father will say, why don't we
talk?
And then, who are you going to talk
to? Whatever you also carry my bad junior till around the giddy, but we're giddy. Then, come on, Rosa, I'm a bad junior.
He said, don't forget that before you became so and so's father, you were so and so.
Who's seven in some way?
Playing with opportunity.
Can you not give my mama so on your money and my four and my WhatsApp?
Another story, if you have heard it.
My or seven it's a man.
A woman who played with a
Mamuna, which got invested in Dalama, Mamai.
The father, the husband used a lot of money.
Professor in the Dagadura Nichito.
Because I am busy with work.
Papu Sina Masters.
Here, go ahead and go to
Dalama is.
Here's the money, go to
school. My Papu Sina.
The woman goes to school.
Utenga master's degree.
He gets his master's, her
master's.
And while she's there, she starts going out with another guy. And then he starts saying, I was married to somebody who is not educated. So he leaves the person who gave her money to
him.
The story says,
Ari kutsinjoy, ni bambo wina.
While they were having good time somewhere,
bambo wina so maso ada nyerera pa mayemwe.
Another guy also says, oh, and while struggling for this
moment,
they actually cut each other.
Mpeni woda ponya kuga kwera maiwa.
And the knife missed the other guy but cut the woman.
Ari kutipata mayi.
While at the hospital,
this woman
and started calling the husband who gave her money to
him
and said, why don't we come back together, playing with opportunity. I have seen people at work playing with
opportunity.
Some of the jokes here say that you should not sleep. You know that this shift, overnight shift,
is one that you to which yale, ya
it is the one that gives you money to pay for rent. And you playing with opportunity, you go and
sleep.
Playing with opportunity. I know somebody at Area 10 in Malawi who played with opportunity. When he was looking for a job, he said, God, if you could just give me a job, I'm going to be very faithful. Well, the company gave him a car. A very good
one.
You will be using it and it will be but only one thing according to the policy. Don't use this car to pick up people. At
Njolomore.
At This guy was coming from Blanta and going to Lilongwe. So he saw some white people. He said, if I get these white people, they're not going to give me
glasses.
The guy in it said, don't use it. But they picked up this
white.
When they reached the town, the white people said, where are you going? They said, well, we are going to see the center, and they said, okay,
let's
go with you. When he found out that he was closer to the company had cameras. So he said to the white people,
come down here,
get close to my office. And the white people gave him dollars. When he went to park the car, when he reached his office, he finds out that these white people
are talking
to his boss. And then so the white people say, we came here very quickly because this guy beat us.
Opanda chiani chito idatera chimwene wa pompo.
His job ended right here.
Komaru ni chito nene mapuzi imaputi tawana sukuru.
But this was a job that he was teaching young people in school. This job was giving help to him. But he played with his opportunity. Youth play with opportunities at school. The school here is not the one that you
play.
The bus that we pay a lot of money for in Malawi. When you go to school here, the food there is free. When you are finishing school, there are also scholarships
for you.
But I've seen youth that
Black American.
They go and meet their
brother.
The one who is already feeding. His job is doing what I
said.
And you start taking medications that are going to
take
you. You forget that your father's visas are going to run
out.
We're going to go back to Malawi soon.
You
are playing with your opportunity. That type of school, you come back there
praying.
Or you're giving
money.
And here, when you make somebody money, they are going to get all your money is going to be going playing with opportunity. The other people who play with opportunity are politicians. When people were voting for them, there were other people who were very
good.
But they took the chair. The moment they they left their constituents and went. When passing through people that voted for you, just now
2019.
Now you're going back to the same people vote for you again. Some people, your friends, made already budget about buying a car to take borders.
How you have campaign, you know?
This time of campaign, they are not even sweating about campaign. Because they already made their campaign. They're just saying, let them
vote.
They know that when the day comes, we're going to vote for this one who has playing with opportunities. You know that where you went
and you took
a very big you should have used the opportunity. Some people who play with opportunity. Some of us, as fast as we know, we know that where God picked us, we should not be pastors. We are nothing. We are nothing at all. Where he took us, we know that Christians talk about it. When we are passing up and
down,
they say that this is not appropriate.
When I to be business minded.
Some of us are business minded pastors. When you are greeting somebody, you say, I've written a book, you know.
Business.
In our mind, it's business. We are not really pastors. But we are playing with opportunity. Some of us are not supposed to
live in
there are some who have actually the look of a pastor. But some of us, as pastors, when you just look at them, you just be worried. That type of
pastor,
you play with it. Saying that this is a pastor. Instead of going to pray for people, they are doing other things. Playing with opportunity.
And when I was married, I would
say, other people who play with the opportunity. Those of us, God has allowed us to come to this place. This is an opportunity. Don't play with it. If you have gone to UK, don't play with it
there.
Know that these papers
he's
not going to give them to you twice. Use the opportunity that you have. So I've seen people who don't use opportunity. The moment they come here to the US, they forget. Before they came here, they were praying, God, if you
give
I'm going to help a lot of people. The moment you come here, after you work a few
shifts,
instead of helping people back home, you want to go and buy a
$1,500.
Playing with
somebody.
As they're doing this, they don't even have a house. Let me talk to you, friends. This is know this, that one day something
will happen.
Are you not mesmerized? I'm thinking. I turned around
and
I was driving properly. In the snow, and then
my car
just turned around, and the school bus was also
running.
If I had just hit this bus, I was going to the. I've seen the same road where I was. I saw another car that came from the road and went up into the embankment.
Be
careful. Don't play with
it.
Just think when you're doing the snow and you die. You have the visas and
all
When you go home, the border is open.
Don't.
When people are crying, they talk about America. America was in America, but it doesn't have a house. America here, but it does not have a house. Which America did he go to? Don't play. The chances that God has given you, the opportunity that has given you, God, you can build a house. People who are here, they know that they're here not because of their intelligence. I will not go to this. I know people who have a lot of money in Malawi, but they don't have
money in Malawi. Zangawina, Manawaga, Nango, Peter, Malawi, Tangango, Onai, Menadzivera, Angweza, Utai.
Recently, one of my friends, his son, went to Malawi. But when he tried to come back, they said, you can't go back to the U.S. And you are here. And you're playing with that opportunity. Don't play with that opportunity.
If I have done that.
The death on the cross.
Yatipata, Mbari's will.
Has given us two sides.
What's
the ones who play with opportunity. And the ones who don't play with opportunity. Why are we talking about this? Because it's on the cross that you and I are. We just didn't come here to just talk about the cross. But to say also, when Jesus died, he was put in the grave. But I'm happy this afternoon to let you know that he is not Jesus of the cross. He is not Jesus of the grave. But he is Jesus of the resurrection. We serve a Jesus who is alive. It's not only that. Jesus says, I'm going to heaven to prepare a place for you. And if I am going, I will come back. And I will receive you. So that where I am, you also should be. Loved ones, we have Jesus who is more than everyone else. You cannot compare Jesus to anyone. Because that's why Jesus' grave is empty. All the other famous people, they're still in their graves. Go to Adolf Hitler's grave. He is still in there, but Jesus arose. Mussolini is in the grave, but Jesus arose.
Idi Amin
is in the grave, but Jesus arose.
Osama Bin Laden
is in the grave, but Jesus arose.
Saddam Hussein
is in the grave, but Jesus arose. There was a guy who would turn into a lion. That lion, but that person is still in the grave. But Jesus arose. Go to Jehu. There was a thief there who, even if you shot him, you could not even kill him. Even if you tried to stab him, the but somebody just chewed something and said, he just used a small knife.
Yes!
This person, although he was popular, he is in the grave. But Jesus, you can go to many famous people's graves. They're still in there.
But Jesus was taken out of the grave. And Jesus is coming back soon. Because now this is where even my knees become weak when I talk about this. This time he's coming, the second time he's not coming like this. He's not coming
as much.
He's coming like the King of
Kings.
King of Kings.
President of a president.
President of all
presidents. Yama President America. My president, are you paying? It's a process of Syrian. Yes, I'm a
Syrian. His sirens will surpass all the
sirens. My king, I'm going to be right. I'm going to be right.
When Matthew saw it, he saw that Jesus would come like a cloud. It will start just like a snow. But it will grow. And it will fill up the whole earth. And look, he's seeing some lightning.
And then,
even clouds. When you are talking about that, you look lightning. I'm talking about the lightning that. And then people run away to hide. But on this day, there will be no
rain.
When lightning comes out from the east, another one from the west, another one from the north, another lightning from the
south.
Those are in witchcraft. But their witchcraft is not going to work. On that day is when he's going to come to take us. And when he comes, the angels will not understand it. They will ask to say, who is this? These are the people who have been washed in the blood of the Lamb. This is where all those young people will be very
happy.
This is why you see us marching, because we're not going to march into heaven without making noise. People will walk.
soni.